Welcome to Wayne's World. And on today's show, we're gonna show you how to get my rad friend, Garth Valgor's awesome hairdo.
Yeah, everybody's been comparing it with Heather Locklear, so I really wanna show you how to get my excellent locks.
Shwing!
So let's go and get started, Wayne, before Stacy comes.
Hey guys. This is Garth. I'm gonna show you guys how to get my tubular hair. Okay, so Garth had like this really kind of wiggy hair texture. I mean, obviously it was probably a wig in the movie. So luckily I have this really porous blonde hair, but it's really, really long. So what I'm gonna show you guys is how to get more of a faux bob kind of feel. So basically I'm just gonna section the top of my hair away for later. And then I'm gonna just basically take the bottom of my hair, really aggressively tease it, adding a lot of volume to it. And this is gonna help give it that like wig fullness. I'm just gonna really aggressively tease it. And now all I'm gonna do is take it and apply a really low ponytail in the back.
Now that I've secured it in the back with bobby pins, it doesn't need to be perfect because when you drop the hair out from the top, you just want it to lay over and just kind of have like a ratty texture. So what I'm gonna do now, you can see that my hair looks a lot shorter. So what I'm gonna do now is I actually got the coolest tool the other day from Samvia, and this is actually a texturizer. So it's actually a really micro crimper. So just to kind of create more of that wiggy texture that he had, I'm just gonna go through and then just really crimp a few pieces. And you can see it just gave it a really nice fun texture. And I'm just gonna do this all over the hair, randomly. Now I'm just gonna go through my hair with the Samvia texturizing iron. This is great because it adds so much texture to the hair and it's almost like a micro crimp. And it's cool because Garth's hair is like really damaged looking. So this just really gives it texture and coarseness and kind of gives it that like really rock and roll, like trashy kind of feel. So I'm just gonna go through and basically just clamp down from the roots to the ends. And I'm doing it fairly quick because my hair is chemically processed. But if your hair is resistant to curl, you probably want to hold it on there just for a bit longer. All right, so now I have clip-in extensions that I actually just cut so I could create a bang look. So I'm just gonna go through with my texturizing iron once again, add a teeny bit of texture to these guys. And then these simply just clip in. So basically, I'm just gonna go. They're open right now, so I'm gonna just push them forward, and then where I get them, I'm gonna get them where I want them, and then I'm gonna push the clip in to where they secure them. And now I'm simply just going to back comb my bangs a little bit. I'm gonna be using a little bit of texturizing spray by Sexy Hair for some texture and fullness. I'm gonna apply this product all over.
So there you guys have it. Excellent.
All right guys, so that's our episode of Wayne's World today.
Excellent, and now you guys know how to get my bodacious hair. And if you guys want, you can find me all over the internet if you want, links below.
Party on, Garth.
Party on, Wayne.
Okay, sorry, it's throwing me off two ways. Okay.
Okay, this is so funny. Okay, I got it. I'm like, sorry, guys. Why am I? I'm sorry, I know. Okay.
Maybe. No laughing over there. Wait, let me do it one more time. So there you guys have it.
Ha ha.
Oh, you think that was okay?